Comedian Bill Cosby has won the right to fight his 2018 sexual assault conviction. It could test the legal framework as a result of Me Too cases moving forward. The 82-year-old has been imprisoned in Philadelphia for nearly 2 years after a jury convicted him of drugging and sexually assaulting Andrea Constan at his home in 2004. Cosby has always denied that he did doing anything wrong and has described, in fact, what happened as consensual. Joining me now to discuss the Pennsylvania Supreme Court's decision is local defense attorney Rhonda Peoples-Waters. Good morning. Thanks for being here with us.
Good morning.
So I do want to get into the legal specifics in just a minute, but first, were you surprised by this decision?
Yes, it is certainly a shocking decision because anytime you have an appellate court rule that a lower trial court has made an error, those circumstances are rare.
So the Supreme Court has basically agreed to review, for them to allow to review two aspects of the case. So first, it involves other accusers who are allowed to testify during Cosby's trial. Can you explain why the Supreme Court says that Cosby can now challenge the judge's decision to allow all of them to testify?
Right. Well, in this circumstance, the Supreme Court, the state Supreme Court, will make a decision on whether or not the lower court's ruling that five additional alleged victims would be able to testify in this one trial with one main accuser. And the consideration is whether or not those additional five witnesses became the feature of the trial. Did they express that, you know, hey, this is very harmful more than bring additional evidence to the case?
It's interesting because does this speak to sort of the concern, at least on Cosby's lawyer's part, that the jury would develop some kind of presumption of guilt during the trial as opposed to a presumption of innocence? And that was their concern?
Yes, absolutely. Whether or not it was more more prejudicial versus bringing additional evidence to the case, and that presumption of innocence has now been wiped away.
Yeah, and I think that that's important because we should note that one other accuser was allowed to testify during Cosby's first trial. He was acquitted, but when he was retried a year later, these other women were allowed to testify, and Cosby was then convicted on all three felony sex assault counts. So let's move to the second part of this, Rhonda. It basically is that Cosby had said that he had agreed. He had an agreement, basically, with a former prosecutor that he would never be charged in the case involving Andrea Constan. And because he relied on that agreement, he then went on and testified during a civil lawsuit involving her. I think this is very interesting, too, because it speaks to agreements that are frequently made, you know, involving prosecutors and defense attorneys. First of all, how prevalent are those kinds of agreements made between a defendant, for example, and a prosecutor when it comes to consideration of being prosecuted?
Well, those agreements happen quite often, all the time. And in this circumstance, it's very pivotal because Bill Cosby actually said, okay, because you have made the agreement that I will not be charged, I am comfortable with going ahead and giving additional testimony in a civil case and in the deposition of the civil case. And so now the issue is, did he give up his right to say, listen, I do not want to testify and self-incriminate myself? And those are the issues that the court will consider, whether or not he gave up that constitutional right relying on the bargain that the prior prosecutor had made.
What impact do you think this could have on the Me Too movement?
Well, it certainly will have a great impact because we saw, as you pointed out, that when there was one additional alleged victim, there seemed to be less of an issue. But when you added five additional victims, that is where the court said this could possibly be harmful. So I think that in the Me Too movement, there will definitely be the issue of balancing whether or not the law will allow for more victims to be heard in a trial versus focusing on what that main victim's testimony is.
We'll certainly keep watching this. Rhonda Peoples-Waters, local defense attorney, joining us. Thank you for your perspective this morning.
Thank you.